was really nice. That was really peaceful and nice.
Hashtag things that you don't think is possible to play on neon yellow guitars.
In fairness, that he's got a point.
See?
How's it going, guys?
How's it going?
I'm all right. How are you?
I'm okay.
My name's Rabir.
And I'm Pete.
And we are here at Andertons TV.
Oh, yeah.
To talk to you about some actually very, very good and slightly misleading guitars.
Absolutely.
I don't say misleading in a derogatory term towards the guitars themselves, more about the public's perception of said guitars.
Yes. Do you like a Strat?
I love a Strat.
Well, what is this?
Yeah, exactly.
What is that? Have you seen the new guitars Fender brought out just recently, the Professional Series?
Mm-hmm.
They do a double humbug, an HS version.
Yeah.
HH version.
Yeah.
And to be fair, that's kind of what this is.
I know. It's just got a different name on the headstock.
It's got different
paint jobs. And a few, well, there's plenty of differences, but at the same time, that's kind of what it is though, isn't it? Really? That sort of thing?
It's that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Cuz you know, if you're looking for a guitar, you know, I think when I look for a guitar, when I'm looking, okay, I want to buy a guitar, I like it to be versatile and mm-hmm. not just be able to do one thing.
Yeah.
This is a cool feature if you've got a Strat, for instance, but a Strat can do many, many, many things, unless Paul can do many, many, many things. But
yeah.
There is kind of that thing where you go, do I need a humbugger in the bridge? Do I want a humbugger in the front?
People are happy to pigeonhole, aren't they?
Absolutely. And, you know, I mean, these guitars are really reasonable priced.
Yeah.
Right? About 700 quid.
Mm-hmm.
Thereabouts, kind of like that. They're
it feels better than that. Yeah.
They're made in Mexico. They feel really nice. The neck is just unbelievably sweet to hold.
And they're leery as
flip.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, you don't have to buy it. That's why I picked these two up. So this is the San Dimas.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What is it called?
This is the San Dimas Pro Mod. Yeah. It's the SD1HHFR.
And you might have seen
S2.
You know, the whole reason why we took these is just to, you know, people kind of pitching on guitars. Like, Guthrie Govan plays one of these.
Well, that says a lot, doesn't it? I mean, if these were just made for guys that want to do like Steel Panther, you know, the epic 80s hair metal shred, then I don't think Guthrie would really play one, would he? I mean, he's we all know what Guthrie does. He does a bit of everything.
Yeah.
He's incredibly well-rounded, but
very talented.
If these were just made for 80s hair metal, I doubt he'd be playing them, and I doubt, you know, they do a lot more than that. It's just that they obviously enjoy bringing out crazy neon colours as well.
Absolutely, and who doesn't like a neon colour guitar?
Well, that's it.
There's probably going to be loads of you going out there, I don't like it, Pete, I don't like it at all.
No, but this is beautiful, this is like the orange blaze colour.
Yeah, so
that,
I think they've got a few of these satin sort of blazed blue and stuff. We'll put some of them up on the screen so you can see.
And they're kitted out with all the bells and whistles.
They got it all. What was these here?
That's the JB set. In the that's the JB set in the San Dimas Pro Mod, and then in the SoCal, which is obviously, it's pretty much the same, but you've got a scratch plate, but then you've got the Trembucker set in there.
Yeah. And this is kind of a cool colour. I don't know if you can see that, but that's kind of a sparkly...
Charcoal sparkle.
Charcoal
sparkle. Yeah.
And, you know, with the necks with the rolled etches.
Rolled edges, compound radius.
You know, because they've got the Floyd, they've got the locking up here. The one you have there has got locking tuners on it.
Yeah, Charvel locking tuners.
And, you know what I mean? They feel great, man.
Yeah, and it's worth saying as well that this is the hardtail version. This is the San Dimas SD1HT, and this has got a 59 in the neck, which is my favourite neck humbucker.
Yeah.
And it's got a JB in the bridge. And the cool thing is they all have coil split as well.
So there you go, your Strat tone right there.
Yeah, so you can get more out of it than just humbucker tone.
Now, riddle me this, Batman.
Yeah.
Why is it that they've got that plate there in the back? What's the difference between these two?
This is top load.
Oh, right, of course it is.
Yeah, so all your electronics going in there.
But why have you got... Oh, yes, of course. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool, isn't it?
It is.
That looks even more like a Strat.
Yeah. And you may have noticed these are all maple fretboard. This is rosewood. But to be honest, the tones you can get out of them is far more than, I suppose, you'd expect, really. I mean, it's a double humbucker guitar, looks pretty leery, but as we were just demonstrating, playing on that kind of then if I split it, you get a different.
V40, 1x12 cab.
Yeah, I've got a T-Rex Mud Honey up front.
That's it.
But there's barely any gain on that. I mean,
just a little bit of a boost.
If I take the boost out. So I'm really getting all the flavour from the pedal, but.
Split that coil.
So yeah, splitting that coil. On the neck, yeah. It's just great. I mean, that's...
Play a Jimmy riff for that, or like Stevie Ray Vaughan or something.
That kind of, what, with the single
with
the coil?
Split. Yeah, let's hear that.
Oh, it's lovely, isn't it? Really, really nice.
Okay, so tell me where these guitars sort of, when did they appear?
80s.
In the 80s.
Really? Well,
and it was just modded. That's, you know, the pro mod. It was modded Stratocasters where they started to, you know, where people would put humbuckers in. You know,
just
I can imagine
around with them.
There was a point where people wanted to do all that. So just mess around with it, putting the Floyd on there, on Strats, and then somebody thought, hey, why don't we just make a dedicated guitar for that sort of stuff?
Yeah.
Is that what it was?
Yeah, I guess so. And in essence, like, when you get this kind of colour guitar, I suppose...
I love this guitar.
You're either trying to do a massive juxtaposition on stage and be playing, like, smooth jazz and funk with a guitar like that, which would be cool. But also, you may as well just assume that you're going to be playing that kind of shreddy lead stuff with a guitar that looks like this. But the point of this video... it's not only to tell you that they're great guitars, but that they're not just for that job, you know? They're
absolutely
really not. Which is kind of why we're choosing not to do
to play high-gain stuff. We will play some high-gain stuff. Well, let's shall we hear if a neon yellow guitar sounds any different?
Yes. It's great.
I mean, there you go, look. I can't help it though.
No, if it's on there, you're going to be dipping
the
bar.
You're reaching for that thing, and just that's great. Can you see that? Check this out, right? Look at it. Look at the strings, and I go like this.
Yeah, I mean that's in tune. Floyd Rose, original Floyd Rose. I'm assuming that's, yeah, it's a Floyd Rose. Probably a 1000 series on there for the price. But I use those Floyd Roses and I think they're absolutely bang tidy.
Bang tidy. I mean, what's not to like? If you're looking for a Strat, but you want something more from it than just a Strat, and what can you get for this kind of money? So you can get a Strat, sort of 600 quid-ish, kind of 700 quid. That's like a Mexican or the Classic Pro.
Yeah,
the Classic Pro you played.
Yeah. Which was immense.
Which is a great guitar.
But of course, you know, and then you can get all your kind of mid-level Ibanez, Schecter, ESP, LTD.
But I'm thinking, you know, if you are looking for a Strat, that's just
But if you're looking
Strat
for a Stratty guitar, I mean, the other good thing about them is you're not getting the kind of... what you're getting out of a guitar like this is more the name, the sort of history behind it, as well as the specs and the style of guitar, and the little things that you get that are unique to Charvel's manufacturing process.
Yeah.
Like the rolled edges, like the compound radius, which they make sure, and I heard this firsthand from the guy at Charvel, that they make sure that every single guitar has the treatment like that done to the neck, and it's their own specific tooling.
It feels lovely, man.
Yeah.
You must come and just pick one of these up. Don't let them scare you, because they are hanging in the shop.
Yeah.
You know, you walk over and there's a bright neon pink one, and the yellow one, and the green, slime green one, and you go, oh my God, I'm never going to plug those guitars in, because they don't look very... you know, inviting,
well,
as it were.
Yeah.
But, you know, you then plug them in and you play, I'm in the Sheriff 44, I've got a Noble's ODR1 on the floor there, and just do some...
Mm-hmm.
You can play blues with these things. You know, you do some shredding, please. Because well, I can't really do that. Well, here you go. How about this? How about this?
Don't even know what that was.
I can't do the shredding, man. I just can't do it. But you know, you can do that.
You can do that if you want.
You can do that, and you can do this.
Something like that.
Something like that. Right, let's see if that...
But come on, that, I mean, that proves a point that we just... What happened there?
Yeah.
Because we shredded a second ago, and then we just swapped pickups, coil split, went low gain, and you get that stratty, feelsy, kind of soulful tone out of them.
It's kind of that, you know, you... guitars have to inspire you.
Yeah.
You know, and you have to, sometimes you have to pass the color. You know, some people love this color.
Yeah.
I think it's a great color. I don't have a guitar in this color. So why wouldn't I have a guitar in this color? It looks a bit green there in the camera.
Yeah.
But it is kind of a, it's yellow, isn't it? It's neon. Yeah,
neon yellow, fluorescent.
And it takes
yellow.
Me back, man.
Worth saying that these guitars, they don't really get in the way of what you want to play. Whether you want to do 80s shred or riffage or go bluesy on it, the way they play isn't pigeonholed to one style.
Not at all.
Sometimes guitars can be pigeonholed in terms of looks, but it is worth pointing out the playability of these is definitely more versatile than they look.
So don't walk past them because they are, you know, they are pretty damn nice guitars, I must admit.
Yeah.
You know.
Again, they have the bells and whistles.
Got the bells and
whistles. So these two are the same, just different colours.
Yeah.
Whereas you're about to play the SoCal, which has got the Trembook cassette, and it's a different pickups.
Very like this as well, actually.
Different pickups, but the rest of it's very similar. It has a scratch plate, of course. But you could change the scratch plate out if you wanted. Go white on it, go cream, go mint.
Go neon.
Yeah.
That's a really cool colour. Can you see that in there?
Yeah, it's got the sparkle on it, hasn't it?
Sparkling. Let me just tune this up. Let's try to do some funk.
So they do that thing too.
They do that as well. What?
I hadn't even touched the whammy bar with that. I should have done, shouldn't I? Like. But the point is that they definitely do more than what they probably say on the tin. Is the kind of moral of this story.
So this one is the SoCal?
It is, yes.
The SoCal, and the pickups in this one are different from these ones, isn't it?
Yeah, that's got the Trembookers in it. Trembooker distortion Trembookers.
Okay.
And in these ones, you've got the JB set.
Yeah.
And in this one, you've got the JB in the bridge and the 59 in the neck.
Nice. I like that collar, man. I bet you that's going to wear out really nicely when they
really
get some...
It's really tasty looking,
isn't it? ...going to get some dings out. I wish they could put a Floyd Rose on that one.
But all of them have the feel. All of them have great feel and great playability.
But that's the thing, isn't it? You pick it up, you know, okay, there are nines on here. You know, you stick nines on it, so it feels easier to play. But nines are fine. You can always change the set of strings.
But the radius, it's not super thin fretboard, not mega fat. It's kind of sat somewhere in the middle.
Yeah. It's slim.
Yeah,
it's slim. Yeah. But so it feels a bit wider, but it's got those nice rolled fingerboards and there's no sharp frets anywhere.
No.
You know,
they're well made. They're well made.
It's not heavy. Floyd Rose on there as well. Let's hear what this sounds like. Three-way switch again. Yes, I'm playing a G chord. I'm not playing a power chord. Oh, wow, that's a lot of fun. That's nothing. That's just into the clean line.
there was anything, if there was any guitar in the four that we picked that was leaning more towards the leady stuff, it'd be this one because of the pickup choice. Because it's got the distortion chambric in it, it breaks up quicker, it's got more gain, more compression. So it's going to be better for that kind of playing in terms of tone.
Again, split.
But you can still...
Oh, wow, hang on. Pokey. Just completely... That's pretty...
Sparky. Yeah.
I'm running that on volume, so...
That's so I'm input, running it clean. Yeah.
I'm running it kind of clean, so... It just sounds good. They're really nice to play. Sounds well. Man.
I think the point we're trying to get at here is that if you've been put off by the colour of these guitars, but you're wanting a Fender-style guitar with humbuckers, some nice features like the rolled edges and the fretboard stuff, that can do a lot more than just one thing, then you really need to look no further than the Charvel stuff, the San Dimas, the SoCal.
Links are below here.
Yeah, because... Yeah, they're more of a, they're extremely versatile.
And there's loads of different colours. You don't have to get a pink one. You don't have to get a yellow one, a snuck slime green one.
No, and it's worth saying that we didn't... This isn't some kind of like, oh, we need to sell more Charvel, so we'll make a video and try and get you to buy them. It's purely because we were like, what should we shoot? And how? And then we were like, actually, we both quite like playing these guitars.
Absolutely.
And we thought it'd just be worth talking to you guys and saying, look, they're more versatile than you think they are.
And I'll tell you what, the other thing is that since I think been a... 6 months, a year now, I've been looking for a super strat, you know, just because to have, you know, I'm not a strat guy or anything, but I would like to try and learn all of that stuff.
Yeah.
Like, I've got some slides coming, you know, some slide, and I want to learn how to do slide as well. So I want a guitar which is really easy to play, with a slim neck, with a Floyd Rose, and I think...
Great option to add to the arsenal of guitars, and they're not that expensive.
Okay, so which one? This is the thing to put in the comments below. Which colour... do you like the best? And which colour do you not like the best? And these are not the only colours there are in this range. There, of course, is, you know, loads of different colours. We will try to put them up on the screen, but...
This one wins for me.
You know what?
Colour-wise.
I like that colour. It's really, really cool.
And then it would be this one next.
I don't know. I like this one. I saw the green one as well.
I like
man.
This one because John Mayer plays a pink pink Jackson.
He did, didn't he?
And I want to be John Mayer.
Who doesn't want to be John Mayer? And you know what? If John Mayer, he was playing a Charvel, wasn't he? In one of his little tweety things.
Yeah.
He was playing
the Guthrie sick.
You know, and he's that kind of guy as well who just plays the guitars because they speak to him kind of thing, I can imagine. Yeah. You know, he just goes, well, this is a great guitar. I want to play this guitar. It talks to me.
Charvel, there's more to them than meets the eye.
That's a good one. You take that one. I want to play this orange one. Right, so these are older, aren't they?
Older bodies.
Older bodies.
Nice, good mid honky wood.
Absolutely. Lovely necks, man. That looks good, this maple neck, doesn't it?
Yep.
You know what? It might be time for me to get one of these.
Oh!
And do some. Not even that. What was it?
Yeah,
this
man.
Is not sound like this is Charvel guitars. Anyway, come and take them out. They are in the store. You should really try them out. Don't just walk past them because they got some funky colors.
At least have a go on them and you'll see the feel is great.
Yes. Yeah. If you go into a shop and you're looking for a Strat type guitar, you have to. This has to be, you know,
considered.
You have to consider these. You know whether you like to have a
whether you like it or not.
Whether you like it or not, try them out.
Yeah.
Charvels, come on, guys. I was Pete.
I was Rabir.
And we'll see you soon.
give you an elephant. I already remember the ear.
And you, motorbike.
Motorbike.